let forgiveness wash away the pain. And no one really knows what they are searching for. This world is crying for so much more.
I am a person. It all started in 1758 when the first legislative meeting was held, allowing only men at the age of 21 or over the right to vote.
Won't allow women to vote.
Queen Victoria and Premier Rodvin Roblin were against women's right to vote. Thanks to many Canadian women, all Canadian women now have the right to vote. By 1914, men started to support women's suffrage.
Everybody should have the same rights.
I believe all people should be treated fairly and equally.
Equal rights. Whatever I can do, they can do, and they can probably do it better.
Also in 1914, a social activist, Canadian feminist, and politician, Nellie McClung, held a play in Winnipeg, Manitoba. The play was called Mock Parliament, and it was about a woman premier not allowing men the right to vote. In 1915, military nurses, known as the Bluebirds, were the first Canadian woman allowed to vote by mail. This is a picture of a Bluebirds voting by mail. In 1916, Manitoba, Alberta, and Saskatchewan women gained the right to vote provincially. Later, in 1917, Ontario and BC women gained the right to vote provincially. New Brunswick women gained the right to vote provincially in 1919. Then, in 1922, Prince Edward Island women gained the right to vote provincially. Women in Newfoundland gained the right to vote provincially in 1925. Quebec women were granted the right to vote provincially in 1940. The Famous Five were a huge help with fighting for women's right to vote.
Off the top of my head, no.
No, I don't.
No, I do not. I read about them, but no, I cannot remember their names. Not all their names.
Nellie McClung. Some people.
The Famous Five. I'm assuming the suffragettes and how they got us the vote. Am I correct?
The Famous Five were a group of five suffragist women from Alberta.
So, the Alberta women were responsible.
The Famous Five consisted of...
Nellie McClung, Henrietta Edwards, Louise McKinney, Emma Murphy, and Irene Halby.
The Famous Five fought for women's rights and equality. The Famous Five made petitions and held protests. The Famous Five also succeeded in the Persons case.
No.
No. Sorry. A case with people.
The Famous Five went to the Supreme Court.
The Persons case fought over whether women were persons or non-persons. Finally, in 1929, the Supreme Court ruled that women are persons. This is a picture of the Famous Five after winning the Persons case. It wasn't until 1960 that all Canadian citizens were granted the right to vote.
Women didn't vote until 1960.